Mr. Mahesh Vyas, the MD and CEO at CMIE, joins us to give us some color on what he sees as positive signs. Mr. Vyas, thank you very much for joining us. Well, first up, this stoppage of projects appears to have, the pace of stoppage of projects appears to have declined. Your website indicates that number of stalled projects in the December quarter fell to 135 from 210 in the September quarter. Is that a trend that is continuing in 2015 as well?
It does look like a trend that will continue for some more time. We do see a number of projects which have been stalled or abandoned coming down. Finally, there's only a finite set of projects that can be stalled or abandoned. They have to come off the projects which are on hand.
Okay.
So, yes, there is a stoppage over there, which is a very good sign.
Okay, so, okay. In that case, you need not necessarily look at it as positive. In the total number of projects itself are finite. Is there any other positive sign in the sense of restart of projects? Are the number of stalled projects declining because more of them are getting restarted?
Yes, the number of projects, and that growth is quite impressive. The number of projects which were stalled earlier and have revived in the past 6 to 8 months is very high. It's actually a record. Okay. It's about 1.9 trillion rupees worth of projects that have been revived.
Okay.
Which almost offsets the number of projects that have been stalled. And this is not the only piece of good news. There's also a very substantial increase in the number of projects, new projects that have been announced in the last 1 year.
Mm-hmm.
So in 2014-15, we had 10 trillion rupees worth of new investment projects being announced, which is nearly twice of the 5 to 6 trillion rupees worth of new investment projects that were announced in the preceding 2 years. So that's really, really a big pickup.
And what is your expectation?
At the same time, we also have... we also see an increase in the projects completed. That, I think, is even more interesting. Because, you know, projects keep getting announced all the time. They get abandoned, they get revived, they get stalled. But what's important is when a project gets completed, it produces goods and services, it creates employment, and that number has gone up to 3.5 trillion. And as the numbers get updated in the coming few months, we expect this to go up to 3.6 trillion, which is higher than about 3.2, 3.3 trillion we had in the preceding 2 to 3 years. So that's a good sign.
Okay. So 3.6 trillion is the expectation of projects completed going ahead. So what about an estimate as an expectation of what the new investments in projects could be in FY16 compared to the 10 trillion rupees in FY16?
That's pretty difficult to estimate. One can predict what the completions will be because we know there are these projects on hand and one can figure out when they will get completed with accommodation for some delays, etc. But to speak of new investment projects is completely a different ballgame.
Mm-hmm.
But let me still hazard a guess. What has happened is that 2014-15 saw 10 trillion rupees worth of new investments come in, but the last quarter was a little disappointing, and actually substantially disappointing. We saw a big pickup in new investments in September quarter and in December quarter, and we expected this momentum to continue and to actually accelerate. Whereas actually, the investments fell in March. New investments fell in March compared to September and December.
Okay.
Moreover, what's even more disturbing is that the new investments were largely concentrated in one state of Gujarat. So Gujarat accounts for 38% of all the new investments in the March quarter. And that is a little disturbing. There are other signs that there is some impatience, etc. So I'm not very sure that we will have the same kind of growth as the expectations were, and even as the rapid pace at which investments grew in the early days of the UPA 1.
Okay. I didn't get you, sir. You said new investments in the March quarter fell versus December and September quarters, and they fell largely in Gujarat?
No.
Okay.
We shrunk the number of investment projects, and they were largely, the new investments were largely concentrated in Gujarat, 38% in Gujarat.
Right.
So this is a widespread growth.
Okay. I also just wanted your view on what's happening with the exports, you know, because in the month of March, exports have fallen 21%, and this is the most I understand in the last 6 years. How bad is the state of affairs, and do you expect that these exports, because this time it was about $20 billion, you expect it to fall further?
I am not very optimistic on exports growth being very robust, so I can't say that they will fall any further. But expectations of rapid increase in exports is unlikely to happen. Domestic industrial production has been poor for the past many quarters, even a couple of years. New investments into the manufacturing sector has been very poor. So corporate profitability is under stress. So you combine all these factors, it doesn't look like we are getting any more competitive. Ability is getting stronger. So, if you see the economy from the production side, from the competitive side, I'm not very optimistic on the export front at this point in time.
Okay. Well, if you can give a little color on this 3.5 trillion rupees of projects that got completed, as well as the new 10 trillion rupees worth of projects that were started in FY15, which sectors did they largely belong?
Okay, so if you look at the new investments, the color or the story over there is that this investment is not happening as robustly as one would expect in the manufacturing sector.
Mm-hmm.
So if Make in India is about manufacture in India, which it essentially implies, then one does not see any big increase in manufacturing sector. In fact, aggregate new investments in manufacturing sector is more or less flat. It's actually a tad lower than last year. But the distribution is skewed. There's a sharp fall in investment in chemicals, textiles, partly in food. There's an increase in transport equipment. But gross, on a gross basis, the manufacturing sector has not seen any increase. The increase is in electricity and in the services sector.
Okay.
There is a bit of a disconnect over there, and as I said, the fall in March, the concentration in growth, the concentration in Gujarat, all these show that the growth hasn't been as robust as it was expected to be. All the positions are still far too weak, so one sees a little bit of lower than expectations performance.
Okay.
The new investments which have been completed are a little more interesting, but this is the result of investments that were proposed in the past 5 or 6 years.
Mm.
A lot of debottlenecking happened over the last 1.5 years, and that's now leading into some amount of new investments getting completed. Mind you, even in new investments, the new investments completed in March 2014 were about 1.5 trillion rupees.
Okay.
In March 15, we have just 1 trillion rupees. Even June had 1.1 trillion rupees. So there is a bit of stress over there that I see.
Has the situation in the real estate sector gotten any worse in terms of projects that were shelved, and has that gone up in the last quarter?
I don't remember seeing any signs of increased stress over there.
Okay.
I can't say that there is any increased stress.
Okay. Just a couple of questions more on the sectors that have shown improvement. You said electricity was worse. Did you mean generation, distribution, what aspect of electricity? As well as its services, what exactly would that cover?
So, in electricity, it's mostly generation, not so much distribution. And a large component of that is solar power projects which have been proposed.
Okay.
So, fairly large ones in far off places, so they are kind of, very government sponsored kind of projects. In the services sector, it is the largest increase in transport services, which means ports and roads.
Mm.
So there is an increase in these sectors.
Mm. All right, Mr. Vyas, thank you very much for that mixed picture that you presented. You were running away with some optimism looking at your website data of completed projects, and now there is a reality check. Both the sectoral and the geographical distribution would be a matter of concern, as also the fact that March is not showing the same kind of growth that Dr. Vyas saw in previous months. So a bit of a mixed picture over there. One hopes, of course, that the positive trends are accentuated in the days to come.